Shalom.
Dadah.
Today, we are going from here. We're going to go straight to Borobudur Temple, and it's gonna take about 1.5 hours to get there, approximately, because in here we cannot really predict the time. It's gonna be depends on traffic. Yeah. If the traffic is okay, then we'll get there in an hour. But in the morning, normally the traffic will be crazy, but people are going to Central Java. So we are going to go to another province, Central Java province. Because the reason why you have to be with local guide, which is the servant of the Sultan, is because the Sultan's family still live inside the palace. So there are some rooms you cannot enter. They are the private rooms for Sultan and his family. So if you listen the explaining of the local guide, you will know two unique things about our Sultan. First, Sultan number 10 that we have now, he only has one queen, no other wife, no concubines. Not like other Sultan that we had before. Because the Sultan number 1 until the Sultan number 9, they all have some wives and some concubines. But this city? No. Because in Yogyakarta, geographically we are between on Merapi and Indian Ocean. In 2006, we had a big earthquake from the sea. So we could get earthquake from both sides, from the mountain and also from the sea. It's a bit risky to have high-risk town. The name of the town is Muntilan. In Muntilan, you will see so many. Corn, chili, some other vegetables. In Indonesia, we have 3 times crop for rice. Normally only two times, but now they make it 3 times. trucks taking the sand from the river every day. And after they take the sand, even it's smaller than Borobudur, but they use this temple for the center meditation, the monk meditation. And also this temple is older than Borobudur temple, because they built this temple first, then they built another temple which is much smaller, exactly in the middle. Now Mendut temple is also still used for meditation before this, they have the ceremony, religion ceremony. So long time ago, all monks, after they meditate inside Mendut temple, they're going to cross two rivers with bamboo rafting. They still do it now, but they don't have to cross the river. They're going to walk to Borobudur temple. But before they get to Borobudur temple, they're going to take the holy water that they keep inside Pawon temple first. They continue to Borobudur temple. There are two rivers between the temples. They're going to cross the rivers. The ones near Mendut temple, they call it Elo River. Now Elo River is used for rafting. There are fish ponds the right side. There is a fish market in this area. The fish that they sell here is fresh water fish. That's the market. And the farmer in this area, what they plan is gonna be depend on the season. Because it's rainy season, so they're planting rice. But during summer, they plant tobacco. Because we have cigar factory in Yogyakarta. Tobacco no need much water, so that's why they eat in summer season. That's good. Stop rain here and the sun comes before we get to Borobudur temple. Nice weather, not too hot. And no rain. The center of the monk to do meditation. Actually, we drive from at the back side. At the other side, there is a door to go inside. There's only one chamber at that temple.
How old is the tree?
300 years. The banyan tree is about 300 years old. This is the first river that we pass before we get to Borobudur. Yeah, they do rafting there, body raft. Okay, this is another river.
The name of this river is Progo River. So the monk, they had to cross Elo River and Progo River. This river is also used for rafting activities, but only the professional one. You see, the river is look okay from above, but under the river, they have ripple. There are some caves under the river. So if you're not really professional, when the boat turn over, and the ripple suck you to the cave, then it's very hard for you to. Yeah. So, have to be professional. For the other temple, we cannot see because the temple located in the middle of a village. We cannot see it from roadside. But soon you're going to see Borobudur temple. It's only about 1 kilometer from here. Borobudur. It's from Sanskrit word. Boro is means a place to pray, and Budur means hill. So the full meaning of Borobudur is a place to pray on the hill, because it is built on the hill. You see, very easy for you to see the temple. You will see the main stupa of the temple soon, at the front of us. To do something. So if you ever hear a wise word, word say Satan is it's work here. So if you are not really interested to buy anything from the seller, just keep walking, or just you could say no thank you, because they will try to ask you to say maybe or later. If you say that words, they will take that as a promise you will buy something from them after the temple. Then that will make them following you. So if you're not impressed, just keep walking or just say no. Okay? And
I'm not going to do it. came to this temple to study about the Buddhism philosophy, the Buddha's life story, archaeology, the last day Borobudu was as open Buddhism. It was as open Bible.
They were to strengthen this foundation of temple.
one good asset in the middle of the park. It was
वो लोग जा रहे हैं।
Yeah, in Indonesia, it's very famous, teak wood. This one is the real teak wood. And it's quite heavy too. That's teak wood. You only need to pay 1,000 rupiah. It's not even $1. 1 cent, I say.
10 cent.
10 cent. Ah. Sultan Palace area is surrounding with a big wall. It's 4 kilometers on each side. And every corner, they have corner fort. That's where some area. The road inside the palace area is not so wide because long time ago, it's only the servant of the Sultan that live inside the palace, because actually the servant of the Sultan, they don't work because of money. So the Sultan, he doesn't give any money to the servant. For Javanese people believe if they could serve their king, it will bring luck to their life. But in return, Sultan gives a space of land for the servant to live with their family. So the houses around here,
thank you.
Yeah.
nothing happened. No storm, no heavy rain, just collapse. So Javanese people believe that's a sign that something big going to happen. But the banyan tree collapsed just before our Sultan number 9 passed away. He passed away in Washington DC, in one of the hospitals there. That's the banyan tree.
देखिए आपको कट तो आप ही कर सकते हैं ना हैं
कट नहीं पड़ेगा मेरे को कट पे ठीक है
Thank you.
करेंगे।
तो देखना पड़ेगा कंप्यूटर पर डाल के।
Oh,
Pray for Muslim, they can stop here and pray. Like Kremlin in Russia.
Thank you.
ऊपर भी हीरो देखेंगे
Thank you.
एक ही बात है तो उधर उधर से एक ही बात क्या देखिए ये जो है ना छठा हुआ वाला वो पिक है देखो ये पिक है ये पिक है ये पिक है देखिए वो बड़ा बहुत बड़ा है देखिए ये पीक बहुत बड़ा है देखिए ऐसा बड़ा पीक है हमारे ऊपर तक चलो एग्जैक्टली हम साला इसके यहाँ पे हैं आपको दिखा दो सेकंड के लिए दिखा
जरूर सिगरेट ले जा
चालू कर देगा वीडियो
वीडियो चालू कर सिगरेट ले जा
सिगरेट सुप्रियंत को पूछते हैं ना
हाँ
कहाँ मिलेगा सुप्रियंत से उधर आ जाएंगे अरे इधर पीछे भाई इधर वो पीछे है पीछे इसके पीछे बंद करोगे
बंद कर दो
चलिए ना